The presence of African-American churches in the United States dates back to before the American Civil War, when slavery as well as segregation still existed in the country. Today, this history is being shared by members of African-American communities, like the one in Stafford, Virginia, who now fill the shoes of some of their most astute ancestors of African descent. These are the stories of those who grew up in rural Stafford County, Virginia, and tell what life was like growing up in the early to mid-20th century during a time of segregation and growth. These stories tell of their lives attending church, community fellowship, family, and the future as members of Stafford's historical African American churches. Please join us as we explore their living legacies.
I'm Ronald Allen. I'm a member of Oak Grove Baptist Church. I was baptized in 1966 when I was 9 years old.
My name is Sarah Buckner Kendall, and I have been a member of the Oak Grove Baptist Church here in Whitewater since I was 6 years old. And I was joined the church along with my sister, who dragged me into everything, Joan. And we went to Sunday school here, in the choir here. We grew up here in the community. Sundays here, I mean, being down here in Whitewater, Sundays was our biggest day. We'd get up on Sunday morning and we would have a light breakfast, go to Sunday school, and then when Sunday school was over, we would run through the path and go back home and grab something to eat and get back here by 11 o'clock for morning service. And my mom would bring us to prayer meetings on Wednesday nights. She sometimes would take us to the missionary meetings. She was very strong in the missionaries, Grace Buckner. And if a member of the missionary circle was sick, couldn't come to the church, we would go to their house. Of course, she would drag us little kids along, whether we wanted to go or not. But those were, you know, times when you really learn how to support your community. And being here at Oak Grove, the doors was always on welcome hinges. We worked together as family members, as people grow up, they move out, new members move into the community, and they became members here. And we just came a family here in Oak Grove and here in Whitewater.
My name is Eloise Hicks Lewis. I moved up in Whitewater from Richmond, Virginia when I was the age of 16. Then I joined church here, and Reverend E.K. Foster was the pastor then. My family, my mom and dad, John and Ella Hicks, they were members. My sister, Vanessa Spencer, she was a member here also. And then I had 5 children. My first daughter was Lisa McQuinn, Lana Price now, Brenda and Linda was McQuinn, but Brenda's name is Spencer, and Linda's name is Pratt, and my son James McQuinn. They were all baptized here at Oak Grove and grew up, and they were in the choir and on the usher board. And then my oldest granddaughter, Yolanda McQuinn, she also grew up in the area. She got baptized here in Whitewater also. And she served on the choir of Oak Grove, and she also served on the usher board. And then she left and went to New York and went to college.
My class was the primary class. So they was like first graders.
They just coming into their own.
Yeah, I had like 6 in my class, and every Sunday I had these little 6 kids, and back then they didn't have books,
you know, when you, for Bible, I mean, for Sunday school, they had these little cards with the pictures on the front and the story on the back. You remember that? Yeah. You remember that?
Yeah.
A lot of, when Reverend Foster was here, I remember him when he came in, he really incorporated the young people's choir and different activities here in the community for the kids, you know, to bring them to church. The church, if they weren't reaching out to like organizations, they always reached out to the community. If somebody in the community, if a house burned down, the church and the community came together immediately. It wasn't like the next day that they started taking food out of the cabinets, clothes out of dresser drawers, and they went that night, you know, to see whatever they could do for the people right then and there. You know, it wasn't like today we have to organize everything and get somebody to head up this, that, and the other. Back then, you just responded. And one of the most memorable things to me growing up here, my mother died when I was 9. And she died, you know, that night, but the next morning, my dad sent us all to school. And then my sister and her husband, they came and got me later. Well, what happened was, when I got to the house, these people were all there from the church and the community to help Dad with the food, the children, because it was 4 of us under 18 when my mom died, and how they came together, and the different women in the church reached out to my dad to help him raise these children back during that time. And it was really a community that raised, you know, helped raise kids back then. That was one of the most important things in my life that I remember growing up here. And the church was really supportive of us during that time.
The church is not in its original location. The location was on Norman Road, at the end of Norman Road.
The only thing I remember about the original church is the steps. I don't remember the building at all. I remember my parents talking about the church, you know, and it being, you know, an older building.
My grandparents and my mom went to Oak Grove Baptist Church when it was on Norman Road. And according to them, they said that the church had wooden floors, and when people would get happy, they would shout, and the dust from the wooden floor would come up and stuff like that. And they said that they would have to walk to church. The people back then, they didn't have cars, so they would walk to church. And my grandmother, because she lived about, Beatrice Barnes was my grandmother's name, and my mom's name was Yvonne Allen, and they lived over on which is called Corey Road now. The road number back then was 692. And they used to walk from their house down to the original church, which is on Norman Road.
How old is the church?
The church is 142 years old.
42.
No, it's 142. I think it's 142.
Yes.
Something steal across the air. Oh, give me wings
to the wings, to the veil of faith.
Give me wings,
oh Lord, fly away.
And I'll fly away somewhere.
On typical Sunday, I would come to Sunday school. Then I sang in the choir, and actually the choir was only the only organization that I was really in. I never ushered, I never did no other thing but sing in the choir. And then later on, when I was about 16, 17, I started playing for the church. I started playing for the youth choir. At that time, Bernice Preston and Maggie Washington was our musicians. Bernice played on second and third, and Ms. Washington played on first and fourth. And when Ms. Preston's husband became a minister, because as she stepped down from being our musician to follow her husband in the ministry, then I started playing for the youth choir, which sang on second and fourth Sundays. And Ms. Washington continued to play for their senior choir, who sang on first and third. My most experienced memorable here at Oak Grove is the homecomings. When people would bring food, then we would have morning worship, and after morning worship, then we would fellowship by eating, and then we would go into our afternoon service.
Coming to church. We all had to go to coming to Sunday school and stand for morning service, and then sometimes we had to stand for evening service. But the best part, like Sir Ronald said, was homecoming. Everybody was home. Everybody came home. People would bring food out of the trucks or the cars. Everybody would go to different, you know, people, getting this one, getting that one. We had a ball. We really had a ball. And you felt the spirit, you know. It was like, this is where I want to be. And I guess that's why I'm still here today at Oak Grove. It's been 51 years that I've been here.
I see in the future.
It was the people. Back then, people, they didn't mind reaching out towards people and mm-hmm. and embracing people, mm-hmm. you know.
A lot of people came home
to fellowship on that Sunday. People that didn't live here, who had moved away. And our homecoming is the third Sunday in August. And third Sunday in August, church was packed. People came from everywhere because they had family members here, and people came home.
We cannot see through heartache.
Staying power. Because people continue to come. People continue to come and worship. Our congregation isn't as large as it used to be because we had a lot of death in our church. A lot of our senior members had passed on. But the staying power is that people continue to worship to serve God here in Oak Grove.
And the backbone of the church, the strong supporters of the church, the people that are here now, are the people that have grown up in the community. Some of them left and came back, and they still support. And we just hold tight to this church, you know, to keep it going.
Starting with my grandmother, Beatrice Barnes, Ms. Ida K. Johnson, Ms. Eleanor Pondexter, Cyril's mother, Mrs. Grace Buckner, Ms. Ella Hicks, and her husband, John. Then we had Diggin' James Jackson and his wife, Maddie. There's so many people that has really pillared of this community. And of the church.
There was just so many people in our church. And, you know, I can name some of them. I remember Miss Edna Scroggins, Miss Bernice King, Miss Mary Speed. They headed up the programs when we had the Christmas plays and the Easter plays. They were always there for that. Miss Poindexter and she used to have cookouts in the backyard, you know, for the young people, we would go over there and on a Saturday afternoon, and they would have hamburgers and hot dogs on the grill. When the Hickses moved to town, they opened up their doors on welcome hinges, even though, you know, just to get to know us and to know the community. You know, my sister Hannah and Louise, they both were dignitaries of the church here, and Hannah was a church clerk. And it's just digging Monroe Jackson, he was the chairman of the digging board, and I remember him because, far as I can remember, we didn't have but two. And because he was the longest, then digging went. And I don't even know who was digging, chairman of the digging board, but he was a very vocal person, you know, but he was good. Coming to church here, I used to remember in between services, if we didn't run home for breakfast, the men of the church, they would come out and they stand around and talk. And then these men, they would just walk around the churchyard looking at the building, looking at different things to see what needed to be done or fixed here at the church. And then they would go back and plan how they was going to do it. And that. And I always admire them, you know, the men in doing it. Whenever we had dinners at the church, the women always got together and fixed the best meals. And the kitchen committee was always awesome. It's just, we just had so many awesome people here at this church. I just can't name them all. That had an influence on my life.
Well, and then those are the people. I wasn't a great pianist and still isn't, but those people was ones who encouraged me. You know, because there was times that I was going to quit, and they said, "No, that you're doing all right. That you will be all right." And you know, and back then. The elders of the church, that they kind of like reached out to the young people.
When I saw far and a distance,
a message would be to remember that all things come through you, through God. And long as you continue to serve and worship Him, things might be rough for you. The road might be rugged, but if you continue to have focus on God, things will be all right for you.
My advice to this generation is, one, you have to keep your faith in God. That whatever you do, you got to put God first. And whenever you do anything and you think there's a problem or issue, just if you keep your faith in God, it's going to be all right. Everything is just going to be all right. You just have to have faith and belief. And that's what gotten me through.
Stay in school. And respect your elders. You know, some of these kids today, they don't respect the elders. You know, and pull up your pants, the guys. Pull your pants up. You know, but really, stay in school and stay focused on God, because God is the one. He's the one. So stay focused.
Step on board and follow me.
The thing that I remembered when I was baptized on the outside of the church, because our baptism pool was on the outside. Though the addition to the church was completed, but it wasn't complete enough to hold baptism on the inside. I was baptized on the outside of the church.
Mm-hmm.
I was 9 years old.
You went by yourself, or was it you and a group of
No, it was a group of us.
Was it a triple dog dare, or everybody got caught up with the spirit like Shirley Caesar?
No. No. I just joined on my, you know, my mom or my grandmother, they never forced me to join church. Mm-hmm. I joined on my own. It was something that I wanted to do.
And at 9 years old?
At 9 years old. And I was,
Like I said, I was baptized. Our baptismal pool was on the outside of the church. And it was on a Sunday morning I baptized it. And so you can imagine it was in August because I joined during our revival. And then the baptism was either that following Sunday or the Sunday after that. And so you can, it was in the morning around about 9:30, and it was kind of chilly outside. So they would baptize us on the outside. Then we would go downstairs to change and dry off.
In the old days, however, baptism was carried out using natural water. This is known as wide water baptism.
Welcome to Oak Grove Baptist Church, Widewater, Stafford County, Virginia.
In old days,
in the water,
I got on.
Oak Grove Baptist Church was established in 1873, which means they've been serving this community for 141 years. Congratulations.
In 2014, Stafford County nominated Oak Grove Baptist Church, among five others, as an important anchor for the African American community for over a century, and is still continuing today.
I just want to thank everyone that took a part in this 350th anniversary. The Oak Grove Baptist Church family, just say thank you. Because one of the things that we are trying to do and trying to work towards is, as our theme says, we are laborers together with God. And that's what we're trying to do, just labor together with our community, with our fellow man, where we just can move forward and bring everybody together where there'll be a stronger community, a stronger county. And we're just saying thank you very much for this honor. Thank you.
Good morning, friends, family, neighbors, honored guests, visitors, and Stafford County members. Our trail of freedom begins by paying homage to the past and giving thanks to for this journey. In honor of those who have laid the foundation for the youth and young adults of Stafford, Virginia, and the surrounding regions, this is for you. Oak Grove Baptist Church of Stafford, Virginia was founded in 1873, where the charter members of the first church originated from First Mount Zion Baptist Church in Dumfries, Virginia. Originally, Oak Grove was known as St. Ross Baptist Church. Throughout the years, Oak Grove Baptist Church has had four sites, all in Stafford County, ranging from a log cabin in 1873 to a fully erected building in 1947. Over the many years at Oak Grove Baptist Church, its worshipers have had the honor and privilege of being led by several noteworthy pastors. While each pastor has contributed greatly to growth and welfare of Oak Grove Baptist Church, and all a little different, some went the extra mile to involve the youth and young adults of the church to ensure its legacy will live on.
And nothing so.
of our communities, with a special emphasis on youth. Several pastors have developed and supported youth and young adult activities and committees both inside and outside of the church. Reverend John H. Cross was one of the first pastors to implement youth committees. He would have the elders of the church involve the youth of the church regularly to teach them everything about church, from being an usher to delivering the word to giving back to the community through helping neighbors, the elderly, and providing scholarships to the youth of the church that are college bound. Most of all, Reverend Cross, as well as all of the other pastors before and after him, wanted the youth and all worshipers to know the unconditional love of God.
When imagining Stafford County about 100 years ago, we realized there are things that we have now that our parents, grandparents, great-grandparents, and even greater-grandparents didn't have as a child. Think about it. There was no cell phones, no computers, no electric or hybrid cars, no Wi-Fi. How in the world did they live with no Wi-Fi? Well, they played games they made up. They spent time running around outside playing tag or Mother May I. They jumped rope, helped her around the house with chores. Back then, family was the center of mostly everyone's existence, and the church family was an existence of that. Back then, growing up with a sense of community was normal. Every person had a sense of responsibility to the other, even the youth. That committee role played a major part in families back then. That bond kept the children safe and all who lived in it.
Growing up as a child, the elders of our church converted the youth with a closer community bond. Every elderly member taught children sense of community, from our Sunday school teachers to all the neighborhoods within our community, to share the same bond of uniting in the grace of God, and to hope this would continue through the neighborhood. I like that idea. Think there is a chance we can get to that, but with Wi-Fi?
As a voice cries out in the silence, searching for a heart that will love him, longing for a child that will give him their own, give it all, he wants it all. And there's a God that walks over the earth. He's searching for a heart that is desperate and longing for a child that will give him their all. Give it all, he wants it all. And he says, love me with your whole heart. He wants it all today.
Bow down. Ride on, King Jesus.
Yeah.
No.